Hello, I am Stefan Zghibarcea and I worked on this study case together with the professors from Iași Technical University. The study is comparing two situations in which we compute the reinforcement necessary in order to increase the residual life of a road structure. One in which we use the standardized characteristics of the road concrete and one in which we use the values of the characteristics obtained on core samples extracted from the road. We will have some conclusions in the end. The residual life of a road structure, it represents the number of years for which the road can sustain the expected traffic. It is a fraction between the admissible traffic value and the average annual computing traffic in million of standard axis. The scope of the study was to determine if using the real values of the mechanical characteristics of the construction materials instead of the standardized ones, it is possible to propose a more economical but still efficient reinforcement solution for the road structure. In the first case, we have a computed height of the road concrete samples of 16 centimeters. With a characteristic tensile strength through splitting of 2.75 megapascals Brazilian method obtained. The corresponding type of concrete according to the Romanian standard NP 111 is BCE type 4 with an elasticity modulus of 24,000 megapascals. Using the data from the geotechnical study, it results that we have a bedding soil with an elasticity modulus of 65 megapascals. The type of soil is P5, which is very bad type of soil. Using the Calderon software, we computed the efforts on the road structure and the admissible traffic. Here are the data entered in the Calderon, and here we obtain the admissible efforts. The computed residual life expectation is lower than 1 year, then it is required to do a reinforcement of the structures. The proposed reinforcement of the structure is made by two layers, the top layer, which is an asphalt concrete of 4 centimeters and the binding layer of asphalt concrete of 8 centimeters. The efforts computed again with Calderon software gave an effort of 1.29 megapascals, which is lower than the admissible effort 1.39 megapascals. This means that the criteria are checked and the reinforcement solution proposed is good enough in order to increase the life of the structure with more than 1 year. In the second case, we have again samples with the height of 16 centimeters and average obtained elasticity modulus of 35,000 and more megapascals. This elasticity modulus was obtained on tests on laboratory made on the core samples extracted from the road concrete layer. According to the Romanian standard NP 111, it results that we have a type of concrete which is BCE6. Using the characteristics that we measured on the laboratory on the core samples and introducing this characteristic on the Calderon software, we obtain an admissible traffic, which again is lower than the yearly traffic, and therefore is required to have a reinforcement of the road structure in order to increase the residual life period with more than 1 year. The proposed reinforcement is made by two layers of asphalt concrete, the top layer of 4 centimeters and the binding layer of 4 centimeters. It was also added just to control the cracking. In theory, a geogrill above the road concrete layer. Using again the Calderon software and making the calculations, we obtain 1.75 megapascals, which is lower than the admissible effort, which is 1.77 megapascal. So again, the criteria are checked and the reinforcement is correct proposed. Conclusions. Considering the standardized elasticity modulus of the raw concrete of 24,000 megapascal, it was necessary to have a reinforcement of 12 centimeters of asphalt layers. Making the same steps and computing the structure again with the elasticity modulus that we obtain on the core samples taken from the road, with a modulus of more than 35,000 megapascal, it requires only 8 centimeters of asphaltic concrete as reinforcement, which leads to an economy of 33% of the total cost of the reinforcement. We think that it is required to make a review and update of the standards for construction materials in order to consider the real values that are obtained or possible to be obtained on site, values that can help to have more suitable and sustainable structures from resources used point of view and more economical in preparation. Here are some references used in the study. And thank you very much for your attention.